కృష్ణవ్రతా కృష్ణమనుస్మరంతః రాత్రౌ చ కృష్ణం పునరుత్థితాయ తే కృష్ణదేహా ప్రవిశంతి కృష్ణం ఆజ్యం యథా మంత్రహుతం హుతాశీ బుద్ధిర్బలం యశో ధైర్యం నిర్భయత్వమరోగతా అజాడ్యం వాక్పటుత్వం చ హనుమత్ స్మరణాత్ భవేత్. సెకండ్ ఇస్ పాన. థర్డ్ ఇస్ విమెన్ హు సెల్ దెమ్సెల్వ్స్. Fourth is where there is unwarranted violence. Give me one more place, says Kali. Enter gold. Gold means property. Gold is possession. When people want possession, they would do anything for it. Fathers kill children, brothers kill brothers, children kill mothers for the sake of wealth. That is where we come to know about Kali entering the world. After a while comes a very important incident in the Bhagavata, epoch-making incident. It's the whole history of Parikshit changes. Parikshit goes hunting and feels hungry and thirsty. According to our Shastra, we and the animals share four instincts: Ahara Nidra, Bhaya Maithunam Cha, Samanya Metat Pashubhir Naranam. Ahara is food, Nidra is sleep, Bhaya is fear, and Maithuna is sex. These are the four instincts we share with animals. What divides us from animals is Dharma. Dharma makes us conquer all these four instincts. Sometimes we fall a prey to these instincts. In simple words, when you are hungry, you are angry. We are very restless when we are hungry. How many of us can control hunger? Only when you rise above the body, you are capable of that yoga. 2 hours, 2.5 hours, you and I are sitting here without a sip of water. At home, how many cups of coffee? How many cups of tea? Green tea, black tea, white tea, whatever it is. Something you are drinking all the time, winter. But when you are listening to the katha, you have overcome your instinct. That is dharma, that is yoga, that is self-control. Shaknoti yeva yasodum praksharira vimokshanat kama krododbhavam vegam sayukta sasukhi sanaraha. He is the happy one who can control his kama and krodha. We go for darshan, we are waiting for 1 hour, we don't eat, we don't sleep at night, early morning we have to go, we don't bother. Because we have transcended the body. That is yoga. Unfortunately, or maybe fortunately, you have Parikshit falling a prey to anger. He enters a rishi's ashram. The rishi's name is Shamika. He is sitting in deep meditation. And as he is sitting in deep meditation, our great king expects hospitality. I'm the king, Ishwaroham, Aham Bhogi. I'm not recognized. I'm not honored. I'm neglected. And she gets angry. According to our Shastra, if you don't respect a Mahatma, you are forgiven. But don't disrespect him. Don't insult him. Never insult a Mahatma, because if you do so, God will take revenge. Mahatmas don't take revenge. Adveshta sarva bhutanam maitra karuna evacha nirmamo nirahankara samadukha sukakshamin. Sakubai is that great woman in Pandharpur, whose mother-in-law is to beat her. And one day the Lord decided to beat the mother-in-law. He came as the pestle, you know, the pounding pestle. With that, it was a very nice cinematographic trick. All the time the mother-in-law is beaten up. I felt very happy. Because God takes revenge. Here is a serpent, dead serpent, put round the neck of Shamika Rishi. Action as reaction. Every word that we say, every thought that passes through the mind, every action of ours has a reaction. That is why we have to offer everything to the Lord. Yat karoshi, yat ashnasi, yat juhoshi, tad asiyat, yat tavasyasi kaunteya, tat kurushva madarpanam. He purifies our action, thought, word and action. As soon as he offers this insulting garland, the son of the rishi, his name is Shringi, he who has insulted my father, may he die of serpent bite 7 days from hence. Iti langita varyadam takshaka saptame ahani dankshati smakulangaram chodito mat me tatadruham. 7 days. My master, Anantaram Dikshita, used to say, thank God he has 7 days. We are not even sure of 7 minutes. One of my friends reports, there's a party going on in Calcutta. The wife is sitting at this table and the husband at the other table. The wife tells the husband, I'll just go around, meet a few friends and come. She just goes around and meantime the husband dies. 1 minute. Just 1 minute, he's gone. No time to say goodbye, darling, also. How does it happen? How does it happen? 7 days he has got, and now he gives off his scepter and crown, gives up the throne, wears cotton clothes, goes on to the banks of the Ganga, and he's asking, what should a dying man do? A very seminal question. Let us all live for 100 years. What's best about the Bhagavatam I like is it makes us life conscious and death conscious. We are living in a fool's paradise if we don't think of death every day. Mad we are. If you put death before you every day, you're a wise person. Your whole life changes. Your attitude to people changes. Your value set changes. Your priorities change. When you know it is going to be just a few days more, a few years more. For him, 7 days more. Last February, I told you, I went to Dubai for the first time. I was allowed to speak to my Arab brothers on the Gita. And while returning from one of those tours, I said, life is a guest house. We are in a guest house here. After 7 days, we have to leave. Musafir khana hai, ye duniya musafir khana hai. Musafir khana hai, ye duniya musafir khana hai. Chahe jitne din yah jilo, ek din jana hai. Long back, Purandardasa said, Alliruudu nammane, illiruudu summane. It is not a real place. The world is a make-believe place. Our real home is there. Kahan se aaye, kahan hai jana? Jisko hai khoya, usi ko hai paana. Jisko hai khoya, musafir khana hai, ye duniya musafir khana hai. Now is the time when he meets so many rishis, Atri, Vasishtha, Chavana, Sharadman, Arishtinemi, Bhrugu, Angira. He's asking, Swamijis, Marishis, Marishis, sages and seers, wise men, Parikshit has a seminal question to ask. What's it, Parikshit? What should a dying man do? We don't know the answer, Parikshit. The answer is known by him. Who is he? His name is Shukadeva. He is just walking into our company. Tatra bhavat bhagavan vyasaputru yadrikshayagam atamanona pekshaha alakshalingo nijalabhatushtaha vritascha balaira vadhuta veshaha tam dvashta varsham sukumara pada karuru bakvamsa kapola gatram. Very sweet looking boy called Shukadeva, surrounded by children. Children are looking at him. He's a wonderful person. Children are innocent. When they see somebody very divine, they surround him. Vritascha balair avadhuta veshaha. He is an avadhuta. They are looking at him. He's got soft cheeks, soft hand, soft feet, big eyes, and he has got a voice that is metallic. Kambu sujata kantram. It's a voice which is going to speak for 7 days and 7 nights. It can't be a squeaky, screeching voice. It is a resounding voice, metallic voice. Swami, Swami, welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you for coming here. We are purified by you. This is one concept I don't want you to forget. By going to a holy place, by having a bath in the holy river or the holy tank, your sins are washed by and by, which means slowly. But when you see a Mahatma, your sins are washed immediately. Because you say, how can sins be washed, Amma? What dogmatic statements you are making? No, my dear listeners, no. Great ones have told me, Yandaro Mahanubhavaru Andariki Vandanamuru. The great ones have said that. As rich men carry cash when they go to distribute for charity, great men carry punya. So the moment you bow down to them, they give their punya to you. So much, so much, so much, so much punya. Because of that punya, our papa is gone. Where a papa is gone, we are purified. I told you the logical reason behind purification. Instant purification. Instant. Tirthi kurvanti tirthani darshanateva sadavaha. Sadhus, the sadhu people, the good people, saintly people purify you immediately. By your coming, we are purified, sir. We are purified. I have a question to ask, Master. I am death hunted, death haunted. I have got 7 days left. What should I do, Swami? What should I do? Ata prachyami samsiddhim yoginam paramam gurum purushasyeha yatkaryam mriyamanasya sarvatha yatshrotavyam ato japyam yatkartavyam nribiprabhu smartavyam bhajaniyam va bruhiyatva viparyayam nunam bhagavato brahman griheshu grhamedinam nalakshate hyavastanam api godohanam kochit. What should a dying man do? What should he listen to? What japa should he do? What should he do? What should he not do? What should he give up? What should he possess? What should he remember? Please tell me, Master, please tell me. You remain in a place only for that time when it takes to milk a cow. The biggest cow, 15 minutes, 20 minutes. But then you've come here for 7 days and 7 nights. We are thankful to you, beholden unto you. Please tell us, Swami. I have told you earlier, no scripture should be given without being requested, without a request being made by the listener. Pariprashnena sevaya. Have I not told you before? There are types of questions. One is a pedantic question which shows off your knowledge. The other question is a fault-finding question. The third question is to dilute it with a joke. The fourth question is a pertinent question. Here is a pertinent question. The pertinent question is for all times, all people, everywhere. That is why, very intelligent question. On our behalf, representative man. Sri Aurobindo called Arjuna the representative man. I call Parikshit also the representative man. Because he is asking on our behalf, what should a dying, marne wala ko kya karna hai? Oh yes, Parikshit. Variyan eshate prashna krito lokahitam drupa. Atmivat samvatappumsam shrotavyadishu yapparaha. What a lovely question you have asked. Prashna ki prashamsa karte huye, prashna ka jawab de rahe hain. Parikshit, life is passing. Pal pal bita jaye. I was looking at the watch. The second hand was moving. Pal pal bita jaye. Pal pal bita jaye. Pal pal bita jaye. पल पल बीता जाए समय जो बीत गया है बंधु वापस कभी न आए. Time gone is time gone. One of those irritating moments is when you're in a traffic jam and suddenly you find the signal. I don't know, the signal starts with 136 and it comes down. My God, how long you have to wait for zero? Don't worry, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Clap. 136 times Hare Krishna, what more do you want? BP will be normal, doctor, naturally. Instead of saying, oh, you look at the signal, no. Everything should be according to your will. You little man, tiny man, puny man, even the signal you want to obey you. You want the winds to obey you, the rain to obey you. How much of arrogance you have. Please make disasters into beautiful opportunities. That is what makes you happy. Attitude. Attitude matters. Whenever I'm stuck in a traffic jam, I just say, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. I have my counter always with me. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Enough time to chant the name of the Lord. Veetla mudiyala na vadiyala pannadhu. If you can't do it at home, do it on the way. You know, this is where he's saying, time is passing, Parikshit. Nidraya hriyate naktam. Some people sleep for 10 hours, God bless them. 6 to 7 hours is more than enough. Adult, 6 hours is enough. Baby, 8 hours. But life is gone in sleeping. Vyavayena cha vavayaha. Most of the time is spent in sensuous pleasure. Divacharthe ya rajan. We are making money. 9 to 5. Money, 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 money. Balance, bank balance, credit card, bank balance. Accumulating, accumulating. The Lord is telling us, Charteya Rajan, half the time you're earning wealth. But for what? But for what are you earning wealth? Please remember, there are 5 uses of wealth according to the Bhagavatam. 1 use is for yourself, whatever little desire you have. I tell people, please don't ask for an anklet at 60. You can't dance. So ask for an anklet at 20. You can't ask for a diamond necklace when you're 80 and you have no neck at all. Please wear it when you're 30 or 35. That is the time to show off. These are dharma aviruddha bhuta. Dharma aviruddha bhutas, asha, desire. So first for yourself. 1/5 for your poor relatives. If your poor relatives and their daughter is not getting married, please get her married. Keep 1/5. I have never seen such economic wisdom in the world. Ever since I read that shloka from the Bhagavatam, I said, this is common sense. Third, do something for society. 1/5 has to be taken out for society. Because you have received from society, you have to give back society. You're just paying back, that's all. Charity is only paying back. Fourth, you have to think of your pitras and temples. You have to think of Shraddha and also coming to pilgrimages. This is the way, and this is the way you have to think of. And the fifth is to multiply further the wealth. This is how 5 uses of wealth have been. Nobody will be broke. Today we live by the credit card which discredits. No? What is the credit card? It is only accumulating debts. We are only living on loans. And then you say, disaster. Disaster for you, not for the country. You have wrongly used your powers of, if you have a wise division of your income, you are on the top of the world. Half the time we are making money. We don't, and by the time you are 60, you're a physical wreck, you're a mental disaster. You can't even enjoy what you, bank balance you have. Your children will enjoy. Please, please enjoy as you grow older, the dharmic joys of life. Have a holiday. Many people plan to go to Mansarovar after 65. They can't even walk at home. How can they walk Mansarovar? No. Please do something which is possible at a particular age. The Bhagavata is telling us, life passes, life passes. Kutumba bharane nava. My daughter, my son, my daughter's daughter, my son's daughter, my daughter's son, my son's son, and so on. You are thinking of the grandson's admission. Now, if this is the way you're planning, what are you finally living for? My dear listeners, I want you to live for yourself, for your soul, and in a dharmic fashion. Bhagavata is the only way to give you peace. Idam Bhagavatam nama Puranam Brahma Samhitam Aditavan Dvaparadav Pittur Dvaipayanataham. My father Vyasadeva gave me this Bhagavata. Say Shuka, I came to give you this Bhagavata. This is the ambrosia for the soul. This is the way you are going to save your soul. We are very happy. As I grow older, doctor, I admire my body. How many things the body is doing, you know? How many multiple functions without a single SMS? Everything is done. I myself wonder, how am I speaking? How do I remember the shlokas? How do I get the sentence? I'm not kidding. I'm not joking. For me, I am the case study. You understand? How, Prema? Where did you get this memory? Where did you get this voice? Where did you get this energy? What makes you talk? What makes you dance? What makes you sing? What makes you believe? A beautiful system has been given to us called the body. Thank the Lord for the best machine. The best machine. Of course, we have spoiled it with the wrong food and the wrong habits, that credit goes to us. Telling you, when is the body happy? When the eye sees Narayana, when the ear listens to his glory, when the mouth chants his name. Jiski nazar, jiski nazar, usko dekhe kitna khush naseeb hai. Jo usko dekh sake, wo hi aankh aankh hai. Jo uske की कथा सुने वो ही कान कान है, जो उसकी तुलसी सूंघे वो ही नाक नाक है, जिसकी नजर जिसकी नजर उसको देखे कितना खुश नसीब है. As I am entering Tirupati Tirumala temple, I find everybody looks back to see the Lord. Nobody is happy. Nobody says enough. For everything else you can say enough, but not for darshan. You want to see him again and again and again. Even if they say jargandi, I say jargandi to them. They push me, I push them as much as I can. I said 2 minutes, two minutes, two more minutes. Let me watch his beauty. Let me dissolve in divinity. जो उसके सामने जुड़े वो ही हाथ हाथ है, जो उसके सामने जुड़े वो ही हाथ हाथ है, जो परिक्रमा करे वो ही पाँव पाँव है. कृष्ण प्रेम से जो पिघले वो ही दिल दिल है, कृष्ण प्रेम से जो पिघले वो ही दिल दिल है. कृष्णम लोकय लोचनद्वय हरेर गच्छांग्र युग्मालयम् जिग्रग्राण मुकुंद पाद तुलसीम् मूर्धन्न माधोक्षजम्.